ओम शांति। टुडे वी विल लिसन टू बाबास मुरली डेटेड 3rd November 2020। स्वीट बाबा सेज, स्वीट चिल्ड्रन, ओनली यू आर ट्रू यूनिक मजिशियंस। यू हैव टू परफॉर्म द मैजिक ऑफ चेंजिंग ह्यूमंस इनटू डेटीज। Question: What are the signs of good effort-making students? Baba says they have the aim of passing with honors, that is, of going into the rosary of victory. And it is said, as is the aim, so are the qualifications. So those good effort-making students who have the aim of passing with honors and going into the rosary of victory, they only have remembrance of the one father in their intellects. They break their intellect's yoga away from all bodily relations, including their own bodies, and love only the one. Only such effort makers become beads of the rosary. So this is the effort that makes us eligible to be a bead in the rosary around the garland of the Father. Om Shanti. The spiritual father sits here and explains to the spiritual children, "You spiritual children have now become magicians. The father is therefore also called the magician. There are no other magicians who can change human beings into deities. So this is the unique magic that only the Supreme Father and his children can perform. This is magic, is it not? You show the path to earn such a huge income. Now, A, you perform magic, and second is you show the path or make everyone study the study that makes them earn a huge income. School teachers show you how to earn an income. This study is also an income. The stories and scriptures of the path of devotion are not called studies. There is no income in those. It's not like if somebody is studying the scriptures or doing devotion for 20 years, then they qualify for some degree and then they have an income. Nothing of that sort. Baba says there is just expenditure there. The father explains, you spend so much on the path of devotion, making pictures, building temples and worshipping. At least a teacher enables you to earn an income. At least you go to school and then you get a job and you earn an income at least. Baba says going to a school is better than going to a temple. And then coming to Baba and learning this study, which makes us eligible for 21 births of sustained income, is better than even going to school. So Baba says, Baba is comparing devotion, the knowledge given in schools, and the knowledge given by Baba. So Baba says, at least a teacher enables you to earn an income. There is a livelihood there. That study of you children is so elevated. All of you have to study. So this is not about just praising Baba or singing or dancing. It is study. And in one of the murlis in few days back, Baba said, just like, you know, when somebody reads a book, then the book sits in his intellect and becomes part of his awareness. Similarly, whatever Baba is teaching us, just like that study, we have to make it sit in our intellect and become part of our awareness and action. So Baba says, you children make human beings into deities. Through other studies, you can become a barrister, etc. That would just be for one birth. There is the difference of day and night. This is why you souls should have pure intoxication. So if somebody gets admitted to a course which makes them something very special, then they have intoxication that, oh, I'm going to become a doctor or an engineer or something else. So Baba says, here you should have pure intoxication of who you're going to become. This pure intoxication is different from the body conscious intoxication, because when you become intoxicated in a body conscious way, then you look down upon others. But here, this pure intoxication inspires you to make yourself better, uplift yourself, and also uplift others, just like Baba mentioned in Sunday's Murli. So Baba says this is incognito intoxication. It is the wonder of the unlimited Father. This is such spiritual magic. You have to become Satopradhan by remembering the spirit. So just like, you know, when a magic is performed, nobody can see anything. But then when the final result comes, everybody is very amazed to look at how this ordinary thing got converted into this special thing. Similarly, Baba says, inside, you know, on the inside, nobody can even see. This is so hidden. And inside, you're remembering Baba, and then you're changing into your pure form. And then everybody is amazed at seeing the transformation. So Baba says, a sannyasi told someone, consider yourself to be a bull. That person then went and sat in a small room and considered himself to be that. Then he said, I'm a bull, so how can I leave here? So that means he found the door very small, and he thought that I'm a big bull, so I can't get out of this door. So Baba says, if he considered himself a bull, he started thinking like a bull and feeling like a bull and behaving like a bull. So here Baba says, you consider yourself to be a soul, a virtuous, pure soul, and then remember Baba, and then you will start thinking, feeling, and behaving like a pure soul and a child of God. So Baba says, you were pure souls, but you have now become impure. By remembering the Father, now you will become pure. So just like this, the person sat and considered himself to be a bull, we have to sit considering myself to be the child of the purified, the child of the ocean of peace, love, happiness, and then we will also become like that. This is incognito effort, so nobody can see it, but on the inside, we keep making this effort. So Baba says, by listening to this knowledge, you change from a human being into Narayan, that is, from a human being into a deity. There is the deity sovereignty. Sovereignty is one centralized form of government. So there is one kingdom belonging to the deities. You children are now establishing the deity sovereignty over Bharat by following Srimad. So the one Supreme Father is giving the one direction which will give rise to the one deity sovereignty. The father asks, is the Srimad that I give you right, or are the directions of the scriptures right? judge for yourself. So what do we have to judge? So Baba says, you see, I am speaking the Gita. And then in the scriptures, it is written, Shri Krishna spoke the Gita. Now, Gita is spoken by God. So it is God's version. Now you have to think whether God is corporeal or incorporeal. And if God cannot be corporeal, then how can Shri Krishna speak Gita? Because Gita is spoken by God. So God must be incorporeal. So then whatever I am saying is right. So Baba says, there are many things written in the scriptures, and then I am telling you something, and sometimes they are not the same. And there you have to judge which one is right. The Gita is called the Srimad Bhagavad Gita, the jewel of all scriptures. It has been especially written. Now, who is the one called God? You would definitely all say that it is incorporeal Shiva, because Shiva is the only one shown in the incorporeal form. So you make a Shivlingam, and that is the only depiction of the incorporeal image of God. We souls are His children, brothers. He is the one Father. The Father says, all of you are lovers. You remember me, the beloved, because I taught you Raj Yoga, through which you changed from human beings into Narayan in a practical way. So Baba says, there is so much of devotion in the world, and every soul remembers God. Why? Because in the last cycle, Baba gave us the gift of making us from a human to a deity. So this is why we all call out to Baba with a lot of love, because we carry that memory with us. Those people simply say that they are listening to the story of the true Narayan, that is Satyanarayan Katha. And in the story, it is said that anybody who listens to this story changes from a human into Satyanarayan, that is true Narayan. But then Baba says, although they listen to that story, they are not convinced that they will become Narayan. So nobody thinks that I'm going to become Narayan. So Baba says, this is the true story which I am telling you, and you should have the faith that we are changing from humans to deities. They don't believe that they can change from human beings into Narayan by doing that. The Father is giving each of you souls a third eye of knowledge, through which you know about souls. A soul cannot speak without a body. The place of residence of souls is called the land of Nirvana. Nirvana means beyond sound. So because in the residence of souls, the souls don't have bodies, so we are naked there, so without a body. So that is why there is no sound, because a soul cannot speak without a body. So Baba says, now you understand a soul through your third eye. So third eye is the eye of understanding, and Baba gives us the understanding of that which we can't see or hear or perceive through five senses. So we can see the home with the third eye. We can see what a soul is like. We can see what Baba is like. We can see what the golden age is like through this eye of understanding. So Baba says, you children now have to remember the land of peace and the land of happiness. Remove the land of sorrow from your intellect. So Baba says, I have given you the understanding, and from your third eye, you keep seeing the land of peace and land of happiness, and remove your intellect, withdraw or pull your intellect or unplug your intellect from this world of sorrow. Don't give it any attention. Just withdraw your intellect from this world of sorrow. So Baba says that you souls have now received the understanding of what is right and what is wrong, the significance of actions, neutral actions, and sinful actions has also been explained to you. The father only explains to you children, and only you children understand these things. So nobody knows the difference between right and wrong, true and untrue. Nobody knows what sinful actions are, what neutral actions are, what actions are. So they don't know the difference between soul consciousness, body consciousness, and how in body consciousness all our actions become sinful. So we have been given all this understanding, knowledge, third eye, this ability to judge and discern what's good and bad, right and wrong by Baba. So Baba says, the father only explains to you children, and only you children understand these things. No other human beings even know the father. The father says, this drama is predestined. In Ravan's kingdom, everyone's actions are sinful, because in Ravan's kingdom, everyone is body conscious, and therefore body consciousness is the root of all vices. So nobody is performing any neutral or good actions in Ravan's kingdom. In the golden age, all actions are neutral. Why? Because in the golden age, there is no knowledge of vices. So the deities are ignorant of vices. They don't even know what vices are. So that is why whatever they do is counts as neutral action. Some ask, aren't any children born there? Tell them, this is called the viceless world. So where could the five vices come from? So Baba says, everything happens there. You eat, sleep, wake up, you run a kingdom, children are produced. But then there are no vices, so nothing happens in a vicious way. So Baba says it is a viceless world. This is a very simple thing. The father sits here and explains it. Therefore, those who understand this to be right very quickly become alert. Those who don't understand this might do so as they make further progress. So Baba says, all right, even if somebody doesn't understand this today, it is okay. They will understand it tomorrow. So Baba says that moths come to a flame, leave, and then return. That one is the flame. So many children come, then they don't understand, then they leave, but they also return. Everyone is to be burnt in the flame. This is just an explanation. So this is an analogy. There is no flame as such. That is a common thing. Many moths burn in a flame. At Deepavali, so many tiny insects emerge and then die. They take birth and then die. The father explains, they come at the end, take birth and die again. So Baba says, just like the small insects that come, have a very short lifespan and die. So Baba says, souls who come at the end are like that. They have the life of a mosquito or an insect. So Baba says, now that it is the time to create a fortune, you should create the fortune of a long life. Why should we choose to become insects when we can choose to become those with worthy and long lives? So Baba says that they are just like insects. The father has come to give you your inheritance. Therefore, you have to make effort to pass with honors. Good students make plenty of effort. This rosary is of those who pass with honors. Continue to make as much effort as possible. It is said there are those whose intellects have no love at the time of destruction. So Baba says those whose intellects have no love at the time of destruction get destroyed. It is sung like that. So Baba says, what is this about? It is about those souls who have no love for God at the time of destruction. So they do not win, they die. They are like those moths who get burnt at the end. So Baba says, now you have love in your intellects for Baba, and Baba's love makes you do as Baba says. And then when you do as Baba says, you become very powerful. And then even when there is destruction, you don't feel like being destroyed, you feel like being a winner. So Baba says that you can explain this. Our intellects are loving to the Father. We remember no one but the Father. The Father says, renounce your bodies and all your bodily relations and constantly remember me alone. So do not let your intellect pulled by your body or bodily relations. Just remember me. Let your intellect always point north. So the magnet is there, so let it point north. On the path of devotion, you have been remembering me a lot and saying, O remover of sorrow, bestower of happiness. Therefore, the Father is definitely the bestower of happiness. Heaven is called the land of happiness. The Father says, I have come to purify you. I come and shower the rain of knowledge on the children who have been burnt by sitting on the pyre of lust. So now that we are being showered by the rain of knowledge, then burning, that, those ashes will get washed away and we will be clean again. I teach you children yoga. Remember the Father, and your sins will be absolved, and you will become the masters of the land of angels. You are also magicians. You children should have the intoxication of your true magic. Some magicians are very good and clever. They can make so many things emerge. This magic, however, is unique. No one but the one can teach it. So no magician in the world can teach how to transform a human into a deity. You know that you are changing from human beings into deities. These teachings are for the new world. That is called the golden age, the new world. So Baba is teaching us how to be viceless by removing our intellects from the vicious world and taking it to the ocean of purity and into the pure world. So Baba says, I am teaching you this knowledge which makes you viceless because this teaching is for the new world where no vices exist. You are now at the confluence age. No one knows about this most elevated confluence age. You are becoming such elevated humans. The Father only explains to you souls. When you Brahmin teachers take class, it is your duty first of all to caution everyone. Say, brothers and sisters, sit here considering yourselves to be souls. So just like when a drill starts, the drill master tells everybody to stand in a position of attention. So Baba says, you Brahmin teachers also first make everybody pay attention to their stage and let them come back to who they are first before they learn from the Father. Let them take their position as a soul. Remember that I, the soul, am listening through these ears to what Baba, my father, is saying. So Baba says, I, this soul, am listening through these organs. The Father has also explained to you the secrets of 84 births. Which human beings take 84 births? Not everyone takes them because the population is gradually increasing. So not everyone takes equal number of births. No one even thinks about this. They simply say it's true to whatever they hear. When someone says that Hanuman emerged from the wind, they say it's true. Then they continue to relate such stories to others who continue to say, "It's true, it's true." Each of you children has now received an eye of knowledge with which you understand what is right and what is wrong. So Baba says that nobody can emerge from a wind. So Baba says human beings, they have to take birth through bodies. The only thing is it will not be in a vicious way, but a wiseless way. But you can't emerge from the wind. So Baba says, this is what Baba tells, what is true and what is not true. What is possible, what is not possible. Therefore, you must only perform right actions. Now that you understand what are right actions and wrong actions, so you must perform right actions. So what are right actions? Remembering bodily beings, wrong. Remembering Baba, right. Yes. Remembering the past, wrong. Remembering the future and our deity kingdom, right. So Baba says, now that I have told you what is right and what is wrong, do right actions. You must also explain that you are receiving this inheritance from the unlimited Father. All of you have to make effort. That Father is the Father of all souls. The Father is telling you, souls, now remember me. Consider yourselves to be souls. Sanskars are in each soul. Souls carry their sanskars with them. When someone's name is glorified in childhood, it is understood that he performed such actions in his previous birth. So you have seen child prodigies. So those children who at the age of 3 or 4 or 5, they demonstrate exemplary talent, and then you understand that this is not possible based on the effort that they made in this birth. So you understand these are sanskars that they are carrying from previous births. So Baba says, when a soul leaves one body and takes another, then they carry two things, that is sanskars and the balance of karma. Now, according to karma, they receive the context in which they are born. So some are born rich, poor, healthy, unhealthy, with a good intellect, with a bad intellect. That's karma. And then Baba says, then you also carry the sanskars you create. So if you have been an engineer, you carry the sanskars of an engineer. Or if you've been a master of scriptures, then you carry that sanskar. So Baba says these are the two things that the soul carries. So Baba is also, what is Baba teaching us now? To create divine sanskars, those sanskars which will serve us in the golden age. And to carry that account of karma, that account of charitable actions, punya karma, which will make us eligible to be born as a king, as a double crowned prince there. So Baba says, if someone built a college in his previous birth, he would receive a good education in his present birth. So that is karma. There is that karmic account of actions. In the golden age, there is no question of sinful actions. So you can't have sinful sanskars with you. This is why Baba today said that you are studying for the future. So Baba says, you definitely perform actions there, you rule there, eat there, but you do not perform any wrong actions. So Baba says, there is action, but there are no sinful actions there. That is called the kingdom of Rama. This is the kingdom of Ravan. You are now establishing the kingdom of Rama by following Srimad. So Srimad makes you create those sanskars and those karma which enable you to be eligible to find a place in the kingdom of Rama. That is the new world. Not even a shadow of the deities can exist in the old world. So although we on Deepavali we invoke Sri Lakshmi, but Sri Lakshmi can't come in this new world. Baba says, if you were to place an idol of Lakshmi here, there would be a shadow of it, but there could not be a shadow of the living Lakshmi. So Baba says, let alone Lakshmi, the shadow of the living Lakshmi also cannot enter here. You children know that everyone has to take rebirth. A water wheel continues to turn. This cycle of yours also continues to turn. So have you seen that water wheel on these wells? So there is a water wheel and then it is used to lift the bucket, and then as soon as the bucket is lifted, again the wheel rotates and comes back to its own position. So Baba says, this is also like the cycle. So the cycle also continues to turn. These things are explained using examples. Purity is the best thing because a Kumari is pure. Everyone bows down to her. So on Navratris, everybody, you know, rich, poor alike, they bow down to Kumaris. And they request them to receive the bhog that they prepared. So Baba says, purity is held in high esteem. So Baba says, you are Prajapita, Brahma, Kumars and Kumaris. So you are also defined by your purity. So just like a Kumari is praised because of her purity, you are Prajapita, Brahma, Kumars and Kumaris. So you are also defined by your purity. The majority of you are Kumaris, and this is why it is remembered that the arrows were shot by Kumaris. So the arrows of knowledge were shot by the Kumaris who practiced purity. Those arrows were arrows of knowledge. You sit and explain to them with a lot of love. The Father Satguru is only one. He is the bestower of salvation for all. God speaks man, mana, bhav. This is also a mantra. So just like, you know, in the world, what they do is they chant the mantra with the mouth. But Baba says, this is a different kind of mantra in which you have to situate yourself in the... Remember Baba. So you become an embodiment of this mantra. It requires effort to consider yourselves to be a soul and remember the Father. This effort is incognito. Souls have become tamopradhan and have to become satupradhan once again. The Father has explained, souls and the Supreme Soul have remained separated for a long time. Those who became separated first are the ones who meet Him first. So we are meeting Baba the way we got separated. That is why the ones who got separated first, that is the ones who came down earliest to the golden age, those are the ones who meet Baba first when Baba comes. This is why the Father says, beloved, long lost and now found children. The Father knows when you began worshipping. It is half and half. For half the cycle, there is knowledge, and for half the cycle, there is worshipping. There is day and night. In 24 hours, there are 12 hours a.m. and 12 hours p.m. The cycle too is half and half. There is the day of Brahma and the night of Brahma. So why have they given the Iron Age such a long duration? Baba says, it is nature's law that everything is half and half. So Baba says, so it can't be that the Iron Age is longer than, so the time of happiness and the time of sorrow are equal. So it's not like the Iron Age is much, much longer and the Golden Age is very short. No, Baba says it is half and half. So Baba has explained, it is 5,000 years and 2,500 years day of Brahma, 2,500 years night of Brahma. You can now explain to them what is right and what is wrong. All the scriptures belong to the path of devotion. God comes and gives the fruit of devotion. What is the fruit of devotion? It is knowledge which makes us earn an income and then go to the golden age based on that income. He is called the protector of devotees. As you make further progress, you will sit with sannyasis and explain to them with a lot of love. So Baba said it is sung that the Kumari shot arrows. And it is said that the Kumari shot arrows to Bhishma Pitama. So Bhishma Pitama stand for these sannyasis who are ruling today. So Baba says, you will explain to the sannyasis, you pure Kumaris will have a shot with the arrows of knowledge to the sannyasis. So Baba says, you will explain them with a lot of love. They will not fill in the form that you ask them to. They don't give their personal details. They would not write down the name of their mother and father. So Baba says, you don't have to ask them for it. Some may do this. Baba used to go and ask them why they renounced everything. They renounce vices and also renounce their household. So because they think that the household and the vices are the same. So if you want to renounce the house vices, you have to renounce the household. But what does Baba teach us? Baba says, you now renounce the whole of the old world. That is, now one thing that Baba has explained to us is that the world doesn't exist there, it exists here. So when we withdraw our intellect from the old world and we turn it to the new world, then we have renounced the whole of old world. We don't have to renounce the place where we are in. We just have to withdraw our intellect from the old world. You have been given visions of the new world. So we understand the new world through the third eye. We have received a vision. So we can turn our intellect towards the new world. That is the viceless world. Heavenly God, the Father, is the one who establishes heaven. So you have to turn your attention to the viceless world. And when you turn your attention to the viceless world, then your intellect will be filled with viceless attitudes and viceless consciousness and viceless kinds of actions will be performed by you. He creates the garden of flowers. He changes thorns into flowers. The number one thorn is the sword of lust. You would call lust a sword and you would call anger an evil spirit because a sword does much more damage than an evil spirit. So Baba says a sword cuts something forever. So Baba says lust is like that. Deities are doubly non-violent, so they don't engage in either lust or anger. So you have to do away with both now. All vicious human beings bow down in front of the viceless deity idols. You children now understand that you have come here in order to study. You go to the spiritual gatherings is a common thing. They say that God is omnipresent. Can a father ever be omnipresent? You children receive your inheritance from the Father. The Father comes and makes the old world into the new world of heaven. So the Father is not a thing that would be omnipresent. He is a soul, the supreme soul, who gives you inheritance, comes and changes the world. He cannot be omnipresent. So Baba says, some people don't even consider hell to be hell because they are so intoxicated by their body consciousness that they cannot see clearly. So just like an intoxicated person can't see and think clearly. So people who are intoxicated by their body consciousness can't see that hell is hell. Wealthy people think, what does heaven have to offer? We have wealth, palaces, aeroplanes, etc. We have everything. It is heaven for us there, here. Now wealthy people have started thinking that it is not heaven. So this coronavirus gave a jolt. Otherwise, you know, they were all living with that illusion. It is hell for those who are living in the slums, they think. Bharat is so poor and poverty stricken. History has to repeat again. You should have the intoxication that the father is once again making you double crowned. So now people don't even have a single crown, and Baba is making us double crowned. Crown of purity and the crown of prosperity. So Baba says you should be so intoxicated with what you're going to become. You know now the past, present and future. Baba has told you the story of the golden age and the silver age. Then in the middle of the cycle, you start to come down. The path of sin is the path of descending. The father has now come again. You consider yourselves to be Swadarshan Chakradhari. It isn't that you spin a discus and cut someone's throat, as it is written in the Gita. That's why Baba says, judge what is right and what is wrong. You have to discern. Will a deity cut someone's throat? They have portrayed Krishna spinning a discus, and they say that he killed devils with it. There was nothing like that. You understand that you are Swadarshan Chakradhari Brahmins, that is, you churn the discus of knowledge within yourself, and all the demons of Maya get killed because of that. You have the knowledge of the beginning, the middle, and the end of the world. Deities do not have this knowledge there. There they are in salvation, which is why that is called to be the day. There is difficulty at night. People do so much hatha yoga in their devotion in order to receive a vision. Those who perform intense devotion are ready to sacrifice their lives. Only then they are granted a vision. So they make so much of effort, and according to the law of karma, they receive a return and they receive a vision. According to the drama, their desires are fulfilled for a temporary period. However, God doesn't do anything because Baba gives inheritance, and on the path of devotion, they don't receive inheritance. It's just that they make effort for a vision, and according to drama, they are given a vision. The path of devotion continues for half the cycle. Achcha. To the sweetest, beloved, long lost and now found children, love, remembrance and good morning from the mother, the father, Bab Dada. The spiritual father says namaste to the spiritual children. The spiritual children say namaste to the spiritual father. Essence for dharna. Maintain the spiritual intoxication that Baba is making you double crowned. We are Swadarshan Chakradhari Brahmins. Continue to move along with the knowledge of the past, present and future in your intellect. In order to pass with honors, have true love for the Father. Make the incognito effort of remembering the Father. Blessing. May you become an image of experience and reveal the Father with your experience of all virtues. So Baba says, don't just sing praises of Baba's virtues, but experience them and become an image of experience. And then you will reveal the Father through your image of experience. Become experienced in all the virtues that you sing of the Father. As the Father is the ocean of bliss, move along in the waves of the ocean of bliss. Whoever comes into connection with you, give them the experience of bliss. When you are with the ocean of bliss, then you are an embodiment of bliss. And when someone comes in your connection, they will have an experience of bliss from you. Baba says, give them an experience of bliss, love, happiness, and all virtues. Become an embodiment of all virtues in this way, and the Father's image will be revealed through you, because only you great souls can reveal the Supreme Soul with your images of experience. Slogan: transform excuses into solutions and take inauspicious things as auspicious. So whenever something looks inauspicious, then you have the ability to transform that into in your intellect through your power of changing excuses into solutions. And then whatever looked inauspicious starts looking auspicious. Om Shanti.